Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Mr. Principal, Your Excellencies, Members of Parliament, the Chairman and Members of the Board of Governors, past principals, distinguished guests, parents, especially the mothers and my dear children of Zahira College, Colombo. It is 123 years today after the establishment of this great institution. It was 123 years ago that the great leaders of that time and a band of benefactors decided and implemented their intention of establishing a great school for the Muslim community in this country. And we are here today. I am especially greatly privileged to stand here after 55 years of leaving this great institution, because I entered the Sloan University in 1960 to deliver this oration. I thank the principal for having made the complimentary references to me, for which I thank Allah Ta'ala and my alma mater, Zahira College, Colombo. Because the motto of the college is Alhamdulillah, and the school song is Give Knowledge and Piety. And because of that knowledge and piety, that almost every 1% here is privileged to be present. My topic today involves three aspects. Why Zahira is historic in the path of success? What is her role in the present context? And her possibility of becoming a university in the future? A very vast topic that all of us will agree will take a couple of hours. But I am assigned only 40 minutes, within which I would like to have a bird's eye view of all these aspects. The founding of Zahira College in 1892 must be looked into the context of the period. What was the educational situation of the Muslims in this country at that time? At the end of the 19th century and beginning of the 20th century. A very few statistics and informations would help us to assess what we were at that time. The directors of instructions at that time had issued the annual reports, and especially of the report of Charles Bruce would give us some insight into the situation at that time. In 1875, at the close of the century, there were only Muslim teachers, two of them. It means there were only two Muslim teachers in the whole island in 1875. One J.J. Sudar from Narandaniya and S.M. Ibrahim from Putlam. In the report of 1878, up to that period, no name had ever appeared in any list of prizes by the government or in the examination list of junior, senior and matriculation examinations. In 1879, The Colombo Academy Royal College had only one Muslim student. In 1879, the whole island had only 1,233 students in the schools, Muslim students, which amounted to 2.2%. English medium 167 students, Anglo vernacular 315, and vernacular 715. In 1881, the literary rate of the Muslims in Sri Lanka was males 32, and female, the literacy rate was 2%. And the first Muslim boys' school was registered in 1891, the Kandy Mohammedan Boys' School, Maradana Mohammedan Boys' School in 1892, Gambala Mohammedan Boys' School in 1892. And therefore, in 1903, there were 6 Mohammedan aided schools and 7 Mohammedan government schools. The definition for a Mohammedan school at that time was: instruction is given in Arabic and in the Mohammedan religion in addition to the ordinary subjects of the code. This was a device invented by Siti Lebbe to, one thing, differentiate the schools from the general system as Mohammedan schools in order to attract the Muslim children into those schools. So he made the education department at that time to have a category of schools called the Mohammedan schools, where Arabic and Islam would be compulsory subjects. Because this was the period where the Muslim middle class was emerging in this country. Muslim businessmen, Muslim planters, they were all emerging to be the middle class in this country. And education became necessary, particularly English education. Because in 1909, ILM Abdul Aziz in his publication Al Muslim says, for the survival of the community, it was necessary that a fair number should possess a good knowledge of English, which is indispensable to commercial prosperity, good citizenship, professional knowledge, and government employment. And this was the background in which a few Muslim leaders of the community started thinking of the educational upliftment of the community. And Zahira College was the result. The founder, the main person in the finding the Zahira College, Wapichi Mareka says in 1907, the object of Zahira College is to have a school worthy of the community and to turn out boys able to take their place among those of other communities now trained at colleges in Colombo and elsewhere. We aim at making our boys feel high and responsible position in life. What a foresight! What an idealism! What an ambition, not for him, but for the entire community for the next several hundreds of years. And we are here today after 123 years, realizing some of the ideals carried by people like ILM Abdul Aziz and Wapichi Marekar. And the man who conceptualized the idea of education at that time, right, Muhammad Qasim Siti Lebbe. He was from Kandy, a lawyer, municipal councillor, educationist, writer, publisher, and Arabic textbooks. he had postulated at that time of having three types of schools: Mohammedan boys' school, Mohammedan girls' school, and a central Mohammedan boys' school in Colombo. And he started working on that. He opened a boys' school in Kandy, a girls' school in Trincomalee Street, Kandy, another girls' school in Katikala, Kandy, further one more school in Gampala and another in Kurunagala. His sisters were helping them in running those schools, but they all failed and closed down within a few years for the lack of students. The parents were not willing to send their girls to schools at that time. They failed. But the man did not give up. He shifted his attention to Colombo. He collaborated with people like Vapichu Marekar and Ayel Abdul Aziz and addressed a meeting in this grand mosque in 1891, telling the people the importance of education and English education. They formed the Muslim Educational Society, and it's how Zahira College was born in 1892. Arasi Marekar, Vapichu Marekar. He became fully, totally involved in the Zahira movement. He was rich, earning money as the most famous contractor of building this country at that time. Maradana Mohammedan Boys School was born. He became the manager, and he remained as the manager from 1892 to up to 1917 for 25 years. And during that period, in 1911, Zahira College became a secondary school. In 1913, it took the name Zahira College. And so surprising to think back today, on July 11, 1914, the Old Boys Association was formed. What a futuristic thinking. Within such a short period, in 1914, they formed the Old Boys Association. And today, how happy we are to see that the Old Boys Association has become the most vital organ of the school for the last several years. Large number of them are here. I am sorry I can't be referring to them names, because I will have to wind up within 40 minutes my speech. In 1917, the management was handed over to the mosque until 39 N.H.M. Abdul Qadir, one of the another founders, was the manager who gave the fullest support. In 39, Mr. H.M. Ismail became the manager. These are all success stories. And how did they become possible? By the philanthropies. Vapichu Marekar himself built the first building, costing 951 rupees. What is it enough for today? Just two people to walk into a cafe and have a cup of tea. But the whole entire building of the school had cost him 951 rupees. But if you compare that and equalize it today, it may be in millions. Built houses at Dali Road to be given on rent and manage the schools here. In 1906, Karimji Jafaji gave a two-story building. Again, as a founder, he is here. But the greatest benefactor is, I see his son here, Mr. Nawaz Kafur. N.D.H. Abdul Ghaffur. Grandson, I'm sorry. His grandson. Thank you, Mr. Azwar. You will be very proud today to see what your grandfather had contributed to the school. I will list them. 1922, science block. 1928, 6 classrooms from there, and plus the main hall, he was the major share. The major share of the money was donated by Ghaffur, N.D.H. Abdul Ghaffur, for this main building. In 1948, he gave 1 lakh of rupees to build a hostel that would cost 2.5 lakhs. 18 acres of land at Maharagama, and many more. So these were the people who made the story successful by their contributions, selfless contributions to the school. In 1923, Umbich built that 12 classroom plus the playground. And in 53, Mutuwapa gave it. And now we find that for the last about 5 to 10 years, this tradition of contributions to Zahira College has been revived. Many buildings are coming up, including the swimming pool, Furqan building, what is that called, the library building, all that. And Karimji Jafarji, he was a great benefactor of the school. In fact, it was Karimji Jafarji who brought Maulavi Rafiuddin Ahmad from North India during the first question in Sri Lanka to address the meeting in this Maradana's mosque grounds. And P.B. Umbichi, a man from Kerala. Therefore, we find Zahira College has been built up by Sri Lankan, North Indian, South Indian, and of all important was the Egyptian Orabi Pasha. Orabi Pasha became a symbol because he was Western educated. He was wearing the trouser and the Western dress, and he was having the fez cap. And he landed in this country after banishment of leading a revolution in Egypt. Therefore, he became the symbol. I do not have the time to go into detail of all that did. And Ayalam Abdul Aziz, as I mentioned before, became the vocal propagandist of the need for Zahira College, a Muslim educational institution. He was the president of the Movers Association, trustee of the Maradana Mosque, and he continued the work of Siti Lebbe in the field of editing and publications. He who wrote the book, A Criticism of Mr. Ramanathan's Knowledge of the Movers of Ceylon, replying to Mr. Ramanathan on his concept of the origins of Muslims of Sri Lanka. Then N.H.M. Abdul Qadir, younger brother of N.D.H. Abdul Ghaffur. He was the manager of the school for 25 years. And with all this comes the educational advancement of Zahira College with the coming of Dr. T.B. Jaya. I was also given the privilege to address an oration on Dr. T.B. Jaya about 1.5 years ago under the presidency of Mr. Azur, and therefore I do not want to speak much on Rajaya, but it was Jaya who consolidated the past development of Zahira College and progressed so that that progress reached its peak during the time of A.M. Aziz. And yesterday I found an interesting information which can be verified. Zahira had left, I'm sorry, Dr. Jaya had left Zahira College on 22nd August 1948. That means on the day Zahira College was founded several years ago. I do not know whether it was intentional or coincidental. Dr. Jaya had handed over Zahira College or had they resigned on 22nd August 1948 after 27 years of service. This we will have to verify. Jaya brought the stabilization, consolidation and the progress. Produced the leaders and reformers, thinkers and philosophers, legislators and national figures, so that Zahira emerged as a symbol of Islamic consciousness and history of Muslim education and culture. He brought vast academic improvement. Sports and athletics expanded, literary associations, the publication of the Crescent in 1922, free night school, and wholesome midday meal for rice and curry for 10 cents he gave during the war years. It was very commendable. And a vast number of dignitaries visited Zahira College during that period and addressed the students and the staff. Maulavi Rafiuddin Ahmad, Maulana Shaukat Ali, Mahatma Gandhi, Rajaji, Sarojini Naidu, Daud Shah, Allama Yusuf Ali, and of all that, Mahatma Gandhi on 22nd November 1927. And Mahatma Gandhi says in his speech, "The principal and teachers cannot give you character from the pages of books. Character building comes from their very lives, and really speaking, it must come from within yourself to the students." And Mahadev Desai, who accompanied Gandhiji, says in his book that Mahatma Gandhi enjoyed very much his visit to Zahira College on that particular day. And it may be surprising to many people that during that period Zahira College had girls also as students. From 1920s to 1950s, girls had studied at Zahira College kindergarten up to the age of 8. Because one lady used to tell me, whenever she came for meetings at Zahira College, whenever I addressed the meeting, he used to always complain to me at the end of the meeting, "What is this? You are not referring to us. You are not referring to us." I asked, "Why?" "No, I am a proud old girl of Zahira College." I never took it seriously, but only recently I will find that Zahira College had girls also. But I am sure the present management will not like to have girls here. I am not recommending it. But it is history that even Jaya, maybe at that time, Jaya must have thought that the girls also could have an opportunity to start their education at Zahira College. And like my friend after 60 years still say, "I am an old girl of Zahira College." Right. And as mentioned here by the students and the principal, he started branch schools at Algama, Gambala, Matala, Puttalam and Vekanda. This is why Dr. M.A. Aziz, whenever referring to Dr. Jaya, said he was responsible to bring Zahira as a radiating center of Muslim thought and activity. So these are the success stories of Zahira College, because I intend dealing only with about the first 60 years of Zahira College, because I can't be coming up to all the 123 years. Anyway, as a passing remark, I could say, it touched its peak during the time of Dr. A.M.A. Aziz, whose son Ali Aziz is here to grace the occasion. The university admissions of that period will elaborate how Zahira College reached its peak. The entire university admission in Sri Lanka at that time per year was around 500 or 600 students. There was only one university, University of Ceylon. Later it had two campuses, one was at Peradeniya, one was in Colombo. The total number entering would be around 500, 600 students. And from 1944 to 1962, a list that was maintained by A.M.A. Aziz and given to me by his son indicates from that period the total number entered the universities were arts 44, science 30, medicine 26, engineering 23, vet science 13, and agriculture 2. Altogether 138 students had entered the university at that time, a very large and great number compared to the period of total admission to the universities at that time. And of which Muslims were 80, Sinhalese 37, Tamils 21. That is the greatness of Zahira. It's not a Muslim school alone. It catered to every community in this country. And they were welcomed at Zahira and they came to Zahira. Students from Jaffna, students from South India, from Pakistan, from Maldives, from Singapore. I remember Alvi brothers from Singapore. And there were even boys from Nigeria. Abdul Salim from Nigeria was with us in the hostel. OBA branches were established even in Pakistan. So these were the greatness of the founders. I should be failing in my duty if I do not mention about Ayalam Shafi Mareka, though he does not come within the period of founders. He was principal for 17 years from 67 to 82. He sacrificed his entire life, time and energy to Zahira College. He was to be given the President's Award. Mr. H.M. Azwa, who was then minister, tried his very best to give him a presidential award. He very politely declined. He was pressurized to go for Mecca in the Sri Lankan Hajj delegation team. He very politely declined. When hundreds of people were anxious to join the team. And I don't think he ever went abroad as well. He spent all his time for the school and he started a scheme in the school that is being taught by the government only now. Technical and technological subjects. Long, long ago, before the country started thinking of technological lessons for the students, he started the technical education in a vocational center. Motor mechanism, electronical engineering, printing, batik printing, gemology. What a great idea. Therefore, these are the greatness of the institution of which a large number of present here are the products and the others are partners in this progress. Therefore, I will request every student present here today and the teachers, with the grace of Almighty Allah, now Zahira College has all the infrastructure facilities in a tremendous way. It has established a discipline among the students, teachers and parents what we need require today is academic excellence. But academic excellence cannot be given by one person. The principal alone can't give the academic excellence. Not the teachers alone, not the students, not the parents. It is a combined effort. Everyone must determine and take a vow that we will make the results of Zahira College O-level, A-level and all the examinations not second to any leading school in this country. It has to be a combined effort. Inshallah, in another few years' time, we should be proud to say, just as the number of students entered the university in Aziz era, the same amount of students are going for higher studies from Zahira College. Not only the universities, law colleges, accountants, business professionals, lawyers, and even politicians. We must be proudly say we are 4 ministers from Zahira College. We should be proud to say there are 12 parliamentarians, including non-Muslims in parliament. That era should come, and that era will lead me to make a few comments on whether we can one day become a university. The concept of university has changed a lot. 50 years ago, entering the university was a different matter, it's entirely different today. It was to directly go to a university and get a degree. But now there are universities in the world, even without ever entering a school and studying, you can go to a university. Now this university concept came up in Sri Lanka, the cultural universities concept in the 1950s. Because up to 1942, there was a university college in Sri Lanka and they sat for the London University examinations and many of them went on scholarships to universities in Oxford and Cambridge and got their degrees. But during the war years, the Sri Lankan University was established in 1942. In the 1950s, the idea of cultural universities came up with the elevation of Vidyodhi and Vidyalankara Privanas as universities. So the government itself said that there would be 2 cultural universities, one for the Tamils and one for the Muslims. But the Tamils went further. They said, we on our own would start a Tamil university and started the movement and even bought hundreds of acres of land in Trincomalee to establish a university. So that was the time A.M.A. Aziz was thinking of a Ceylon Muslim Cultural Center, maybe a stepping stone to the university. He issued a publication on 1950s May 1. Giving details of how a Sri Lankan cultural center would be established. There would be a library of 75,000 books, seating capacity for 250 and an auditorium. There would be an archives. I am very happy that the principal and the deputy principal and the others are now interested in establishing a school archive. One of the most important things that has to be done and by supported by everyone. Museum and exhibition center, music, art, calligraphy, special trainers to train the students, Spanish style garden in Sarasani style to specialize in Arabic, Islamic studies and Islamic literature. These were the motives of the Muslim Cultural Center that was to be established under the leadership of Emir Aziz in 1956. The building project started in 1958. It was abandoned, of course, due to the various political, social and cultural changes that took in this country. Jaya himself, in the Press Day oration of 1958, says, "I feel it is my duty to pose the question whether it is not time, in view of the changes taking place in the country, to take steps for the establishment of a Muslim university. While we welcome the conversion of two well-known prebendaries into universities, Hindu and Christian universities in the making, we Muslims will be failing in our duty if, unmindful of the inspiring lead Muslims have given the world in higher and university education, we look on with folded arms on the rapidly developing situation in the country, which may leave us out of the reckoning as nationals worthy of consideration and attention in any scheme of national reconstruction." Through this quotation, Dr. T.B. Jaya has told the community that it was time to seriously consider the establishment of a university for the Muslims. The matter came up in the budget speech and in the opening speech of the Governor General of Parliament in 1961, where two matters were mentioned by the Governor General on the day of opening of Parliament. One, setting up a university grants commission for all the three universities, University of Ceylon, Vidyodhi and Vidyalankara. And number two, establishment of two cultural universities, one for Tamil language and Hindu culture, Arabic language and Muslim culture. So this idea, the concept of a university based on the Muslim preferences, is there for the last 60 years. Therefore, there is nothing wrong in reviving this idea. Because even on that day, on the vote of thanks to the president, to the Governor General speech in opening of Parliament, A.M. Aziz has spoken elaborately on that, which I do not want to quote here due to constraints of time. Some time ago, when A.C.S. Hamid was the Minister of Foreign Affairs and subsequently as Minister of Higher Education, he revived this idea. Therefore, it is perfectly correct for the Muslim communities to seriously think of a university of our own. Because the structure has totally changed. As I mentioned, university structure was different earlier, now it is in various forms. We have 15 universities, degree awarding institutes, private universities, affiliated universities, higher educational institutions for tertiary education, many of that. If you are to progress, we will have to have the concepts in ourselves. Because a war or a peace first originates in the brain of one man. Even a world war originates in the minds and brains of one man, then it spreads. Similarly, the same things. Therefore, I am greatly privileged to make this oration today on the Founders' Day. I wish the college progress. I always mention that the chairman, Mr. Fauzul Hamid, and his band of Board of Governors are doing their excellent job. Our thanks and congratulations. The teachers and principals should endeavor to improve the excellence of education in the school, for which more contribution must come from the teachers, students and the parents. And inshallah, one day Sri Lanka will have a Muslim-oriented university. Thank you very much.
The Value-Based Media Network.